Despite the worldwide and intense fight against drugs, the turnover of illegally sold drugs is currently estimated at approximately $500 billion annually. And the number of available drugs on the market is constantly growing. However, typical street drugs like heroin and cocaine are rarely pure and contain large amounts of cutting or lacing agents to maximize profits or increase potency. Law enforcement is using infrared spectroscopy to reliably identify drugs as well as cutting or lacing agents. For such an analysis, the substance in question is simply placed on the ATR crystal of the instrument and analyzed. But since these substances often share chemical and physical properties, differentiating them can be challenging. Fortunately, FTIR spectroscopy provides a complete breakdown of the drug sample by using dedicated spectral reference libraries. A comprehensive list of ingredients yields information on the composition of the street drug. Additional information on identified drugs and lacing or cutting agents is provided by the TIC-TAC library. However, analysis becomes more complicated when illicit drugs are concealed for trafficking. Small amounts of cocaine and other drugs might be hidden in starch, flour, or sugar. In such cases, IR spectra are usually dominated by the hiding substance. In this case, organic solvents such as methanol or ether are used to extract the drug out of the matrix first. Starch and flour are insoluble in methanol and precipitate slowly. After shaking well, the solid part settles to the bottom. By the way, stamps infused with NPSs or legal highs can be analyzed using the same method of extraction. The solid has set and we are ready to analyze the solution. By using a heatable measurement interface for quick evaporation of the solvent, we can reduce analysis time from minutes to a few seconds. For this experiment, we set the temperature just below the boiling point of methanol. After that, the background is measured without any sample present. Then, a pipette is used to apply the methanol solution dropwise onto the heated measurement interface. The IR preview lets us know when the solvent is completely evaporated and we can start the measurement. Now, all it needs is one click. After analysis, the IR spectra window opens and by performing a library search, we get the result. Cocaine hydrochloride. In this context, the forensic analysis of illegal substances by FTIR demonstrates rapid screening potential and a high degree of reliability for the identification of evidence using the Alpha-2. This, for example, helps law enforcement and forensic scientists to make accurate statements in court. Ultimately, FTIR spectroscopy assists in the prosecution of drug trafficking and helps make our world a little bit safer. Thanks for watching and see you soon!